Hello everybody, let's see which kind of questions were there in 2021 NEET paper. We're going to discuss the paper having the core P3, right? Let's see which kind of questions are there and what will be the proper options of these questions, right? So या वर्षीचा 2021चा कोड P3 असणारा पेपर आज आपण डिस्कस करणार आहोत. बघूया कशा प्रकारचे प्रश्न आले, काही ट्विस्ट आहे का नाही का. फार सिंपल पेपर आहे. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इज नॉट करेक्ट. वी गोइंग टू डिस्कस बॉटनी पेपर, राईट. आता आपण सध्या बॉटनी पेपर डिस्कस करणार आहोत. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इज नॉट करेक्ट, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ऑप्शन नंबर वन, पिरामिड ऑफ नंबर्स इन अ ग्रासलँड इकोसिस्टम इज अपराइट. नॉट करेक्ट मीन्स वील हॅव टू सिलेक्ट इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, राईट. पिरामिड ऑफ नंबर्स इन अ ग्रासलँड इकोसिस्टम इज अपराइट, डेफिनेटली. नंबर ऑफ ग्रासेस प्रोड्युसर्स आर ऑलवेज मोर दॅन प्रायमरी कन्झ्युमर, नंबर ऑफ प्रायमरी कन्झ्युमर्स आर मोर दॅन सेकंडरी कन्झ्युमर अँड सो ऑन. सो पिरामिड ऑप्टेन इज अपराइट. सेकंड ऑप्शन, पिरामिड ऑफ बायोमास इन सी इज जनरली इन्व्हर्टेड. येस, इन सी पिरामिड ऑफ बायोमास इज ऑप्टेंड इज जनरली इन्व्हर्टेड. पिरामिड ऑफ बायोमास इन सी इज जनरली अपराईट, नो, दिस इज रॉंग स्टेटमेंट. अँड नंबर फोर, पिरामिड ऑफ एनर्जी इज ऑलवेज अपराईट. सो वी नो व्हेरी वेल पिरामिड ऑफ एनर्जी इज ऑलवेज अपराईट बिकॉज वॉट एवर एनर्जी प्रेझेंट ऍट वन ट्रॉफिक लेवल, ओनली 10% ऑफ दिस एनर्जी इज ट्रान्सफर्ड टू नेक्स्ट ट्रॉफिक लेवल. सो इट इज ऑलवेज अपराईट. सो थर्ड स्टेटमेंट, पिरामिड ऑफ बायोमास इन सी इज जनरली अपराइट, दिस इज रॉन्ग. इन सी पिरामिड ऑफ बायोमास इज ऑलवेज इन्व्हर्टेड, राईट. द अमाऊंट ऑफ बायोमास प्रेझेंट ॲट ईच ट्रॉफिक लेवल दॅट गो ऑन इन्क्रीझिंग बिकॉज इन ओशन ऑर इन सी प्रायमरी प्रोड्युसर्स आर फायटोप्लॅंक्टन्स विच आर व्हेरी स्मॉल, राईट. देअर साईज इज व्हेरी व्हेरी स्मॉल, हेन्स बायोमास प्रेझेंट ॲट दिस लेवल इज ऑलवेज लेस दॅन द फर्दर सक्सेसिव लेवल्स. सो ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री इज करेक्ट आन्सर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग प्लांट्स इज मोनोशियस. मोनोशियस मीन्स विच इज हॅविंग बोथ द सेक्स ऑर्गन्स प्रेझेंट ऑन द सेम प्लांट, राईट. सायकस सिन्सिनॅलिस, सायकस इज वन ऑफ द प्लांट इन जिम्नोस्पर्म वेअर द सेपरेट कोन्स, मेल अँड फिमेल कोन्स आर डेव्हलप्ड ऑन टू डिफरंट प्लांट. सो कंडिशन इज डायोशियस, नॉट मोनोशियस. सेकंड ऑप्शन, कॅरिका पपया. पपया प्लांट्स अगेन आर डायोशियस प्लांट्स, मेल अँड फिमेल प्लांट्स आर डिफरंट. कारा थर्ड ऑप्शन. अँड फोर्थ ऑप्शन, मर्केन्शिया पॉलिमॉर्फा. मर्केन्शिया इज अगेन अ डायोशियस ब्रायोफाइट. कारा इज द प्लांट वेअर बोथ द सेक्स ऑर्गन्स अँथ्रिडियम अँड आर्किगोनियम प्रेझेंट ऑन द सेम प्लांट. सो मोनोशियस कंडिशन इज ऑब्झर्व इन ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री, दॅट इज कारा प्लांट, राईट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन 103, द फर्स्ट स्टेबल प्रोडक्ट ऑफ CO2 फिक्सेशन इन सॉर्गम इज. सॉर्गम वल्गेअर मीन्स जवार प्लांट. अँड फॉर कार्बन फिक्सेशन इन दिस प्लांट द पाथवे विच इज ऑब्झर्व ऑर विच इज प्रेझेंट, दॅट इज C4 पाथवे. सो इन C4 पाथवे ॲटमॉस्फेरिक कार्बन इज ॲक्सेप्टेड बाय PEPA, फर्स्ट स्टेबल प्रोडक्ट ऑफ CO2 फिक्सेशन. दिस इज द क्वेश्चन. So, atmospheric CO2 is accepted by PEPA, which is a 3-carbon compound. Atmospheric carbon, 1-carbon, and 3C plus 1C together form a 4C stable product is oxaloacetic acid. So, options are first one phosphoglyceric acid, second one pyruvic acid, third one oxaloacetic acid, and fourth one succinic acid. So, stable product of CO2 fixation in sorghum is oxaloacetic acid. So option number 3 is the correct answer for this question. Next question, diadelphous stamens are found in. First of all, what is diadelphy? So it is the condition where the filaments of stamens are fused to form two filament bundles. So when two such filament bundles are formed and anthers remains free, for every stamen the filament is fused but its anther remain free. So diadelphous condition means where two filament bundles are formed and in all these filament bundles their anther lobes are, for every filament which is fused in this condition
its anther is free. So diadolphus stamens are found in option number 1, China rose and citrus. China rose means hibiscus plant. In hibiscus plant, generally monoadolphus condition is observed. Citrus, lemon, where polyadolphus condition is very commonly observed. So second option, China rose, again monoadolphy. Third option, citrus, again polyadolphy. And then fourth option, that is pea plant. So in pea total 10 stamens are there, where 9 stamens are fused to form one filament bundle and one stamen remain free. So its filament, another filament. So two filament bundles are observed in pea flower. So correct option is number 4, that is pea. DNA strands on a gel stained with ethidium bromide when viewed under UV radiations appear as, if we want to observe DNA fragments which were separated on agarose gel in electrophoresis technique, those can be first stained with the help of ethidium bromide, and when we observe this under UV radiation, generally these DNA strands appear bright orange bands. So let's see which options are given. Bright blue bands, first option. Yellow bands, second option. Bright orange bands, and fourth option, dark red bands. So correct answer for this question is bright orange bands. It is given in NCERT book, right? So third option is correct one. Plants follow different pathways in response to environment or phases of life to form different kinds of structures. This ability is called, when plant shows any morphological changes with respect to the environmental factors, then this ability is generally known as plasticity. Okay, and some examples are given in book of this plasticity, especially heterophylly in case of coriander, cotton, right? And when habitat changes, heterophylly is observed in plants like buttercup. In aquatic habitat, that plant produces thin thread-like leaves, whereas in terrestrial habitat, that plant produces broad thin flat leaves. In case of coriander and cotton, in the juvenile phase, when the plant is very young, delicate, then the shape of leaf is different, and when the plant becomes old, mature, then the shape of leaf changes. So these responses shown by plant with respect to the environment, change in the response to the environment, is known as plasticity. So let's see which options are given. First option, maturity. Second one, elasticity. Third one, flexibility. Fourth one, plasticity. So correct answer for this is plasticity. It is nothing but the definition of plasticity given in the book, right? Question number 107, match list 1 and list 2. So protoplast fusion. In list 2, what will be its correct answer? Totipotency, pomatose, somaclones, virus free plants. So protoplast fusion, it is observed in pomato, where protoplasts of tomato and potato are fused, and that fusion product is known as, which is also known as somatic hybrid. The name given to this hybrid of potato and tomato is pomato. So protoplast fusion, correct option is pomato. Plant tissue culture. Plant tissue culture is mainly based on the ability of a plant cell to develop into complete new plant, and this ability is known as totipotency. So correct match for plant tissue culture is totipotency. Meristem culture is mainly used in tissue culture for getting virus free plants. Even though the whole plant is affected or infected by virus, but meristematic cell region, meristem regions are free of virus. Why? Because meristem cells are metabolically highly active, and in such metabolically active cells, virus is unable to establish. So we will get virus free plants if we use meristem cells as an explant in plant tissue culture. So correct match for meristem culture is virus free plants. And micropropagation, where we may use shoot apical meristem, and many small propagules are formed from that single callus, right? And these propagules later shows somaclones, called somaclones, and shows variations. Okay, so micropropagation correct match is somaclones. So correct answer for this match the column, that is number 3. Protoplast fusion, pomato. Plant tissue culture, totipotency. Meristem culture, virus-free plants. and micropropagation somatolone. So correct option is number 3. Next question, in the equation GPP minus R equal to MPP, where GPP means gross primary productivity, R means the amount of biomass used by producers during their respiration, right? And NPP means net primary productivity. The total amount of biomass produced in an ecosystem by producers, that is known as GPP. But producers use some of it for their own vital activities through respiration. So when we subtracted the amount of biomass used by producers for their vital activities, for getting energy, from gross primary productivity, then we will get net primary productivity. So where R represents? R represents number one, option number one, respiration losses, number two, radiant energy, number three, retardation factor, number four, environmental factor. So correct answer for this R is respiration losses. Because in respiration, food is oxidized for producing energy in the form of ATP, which can be later used for various vital processes in the cell, right? So correct answer for 108, that is 1, respiration losses. Next question, the production of gametes by the parents, formation of zygote, the F1 and F2 plants can be understood from a diagram called. Now when we perform any cross in genetics field, and what will be the resulting progeny? What will be its genotypic and phenotypic expression? To understand this, a diagram is introduced by Reginald C. Punnett. And today that square diagram is very popularly known as Punnett square. So let's see which options are given. Net square, first option. Bullet square, second option. Punch square, third option. And fourth option, Punnett square. So correct answer should be Punnett square. Which of the following is an incorrect statement? Statement number one, that is option number one. Nuclear pores act as passages for proteins and RNA molecules in both directions between nucleus and cytoplasm. Second option, is this option correct? First one, yes. Nuclear pores are for the material exchange between cytoplasm and nucleoplasm, right? So correct. Mature sieve tube, second option. Mature sieve tube elements possess a conspicuous nucleus and usual cytoplasmic organelles. Now sieve tube is one of the element in plants where nucleus is generally absent, and small cell organelles like ribosomes, mitochondria are definitely present, but membranous cell organelles like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus generally absent in sieve tube. Okay, so this statement is wrong. Microbodies are present both in plant and animal cells. Yes, there are various kinds of microbodies present, spherosomes, glyoxysomes, peroxisomes. So these microbodies found in both plant and animal cells. Number four, the perinuclear space forms a barrier between the materials present inside the nucleus and that of cytoplasm. Yes, correct. So option number 1, 3, 4 are correct. Second option is wrong, and that is the correct answer for this question. So correct answer for this question is number 2. Now again the next question is match the columns. Lenticels first, in that first column, the first structure given is lenticels. What are lenticels? Let's see what are given in, or which kind of explanation is given in column number 2. Phellogen, suberin deposition, exchange of gases, phellula. We know very well lenticels are present in the bark of trees, and these are especially useful for exchange of gases. Cork cambium, another name is phellogen. Secondary cortex, another name is phelloderm. And cork cell shows suberin deposition, so they become impermeable to water. So correct matching for this, match the column is number 3, lenticels, exchange of gases, cork cambium, phellogen, secondary cortex, phelloderm, and cork, suberin deposition. So correct answer is number 3. The amount of nutrients such as carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus and calcium present in the soil at any given time is referred as, this is the definition of standing state, amount of nutrients present in the soil at any given time, that is standing state. Amount of biomass present in an ecosystem at any given time is known as standing crop, right? So correct answer here is standing state. Let's see which option is this. First option, standing crop. Second option, climax. Third option, climax community. And fourth one, standing state. So for amount of nutrients, the definition is of standing state, and for amount of biomass, definition will be standing crop. So here correct answer option is number 4, that is standing state. Next question, the term used for transfer of pollen grains from anthers of one plant to the stigma of a different plant, which during pollination brings genetically different types of pollen grains to stigma, is. When genetically different types of pollen grains are accepted, then the process of pollination is mainly known as xenogamy, right? Where pollen grains are transferred from stamen to the or from anther to the stigma of the flower present on different plant of different species or same species, right? So xenogamy here in the given option is correct one. First option given is cleistogamy. Cleistogamy means where the floral bud never opens in its lifetime. So obviously that plant should go for self-pollination. So cleistogamy is one of the obligatory mechanism for self-pollination. Second option, xenogamy, right? Whatever the question is given, for that the correct answer is xenogamy, the term used for transfer of pollen grains from anthers of one plant to the stigma of different plant, which during pollination brings genetically different types of pollen grains to stigma. So here pollination occurs between different species of same genus, right? So xenogamy is correct. Gitanogamy or gitanogamy, it is the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of different flower but present on the same plant. So mother plant is same, hence genetic makeup of these two flower is same, so that is gitanogamy. And chasmogamy means where flower generally opens and they may receive even foreign pollen grains, right? So correct answer in this question is xenogamy, number 2. Which of the following stages of meiosis involves division of centromere? The stages given in the option, those are of meiosis. Meiosis occurs in two steps, meiosis 1, meiosis 2. Actually the cell cycle where the meiosis takes place, there are two phases, interphase and M phase. And M phase is further classified as karyokinesis and cytokinesis. So meiosis 1, M phase 1. In that karyokinesis, there are prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, telophase 1. And M phase 2, again in karyokinesis 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, then anaphase 2 and telophase 2. So these kind of divisions occurs during meiosis. In the given option, let's see in which stage division of centromere occurs. In meiosis 1, especially in anaphase 1, only homologous chromosomes are separated from each other. There is no division of centromere. But in anaphase 2, in each chromosome, division of centromere occurs, as a result of which the daughter chromosomes are separated. So let's see which options are given. Option number 1, telophase 2. Number 2, metaphase 1. Number 3, metaphase 2. And number 4, anaphase 2. So correct answer, in which phase centromere divides, that is anaphase 2. So option number 4 is correct. Which of the following is a correct sequence of steps in PCR? Polymerase chain reaction is a synthetic method of gene amplification. In vitro amplification of gene occurs in this method, which was first discovered by Karimulis. So the correct sequence of steps in PCR are, first one, denaturation, second one, annealing, and third one, extension or polymerization. So let's see which option is correct here. First option, annealing, denaturation, extension. Second option, denaturation, annealing, extension. Third option, denaturation, extension, annealing. Fourth option, extension, denaturation, annealing. So second option, denaturation, annealing, extension, is the correct answer. Next question, 116. When gene targeting involving gene amplification is attempted in an individual's tissue to treat disease is known as
gene targeting involving gene amplification is attempted in an individual's tissue to treat the disease. If suppose there is any genetic disorder and a gene is defective in an individual's body, nowadays with the help of gene therapy we may replace that defective copy of gene by correct or normal copy of gene, right? So this process, gene targeting involving gene amplification is attempted in an individual's tissue to treat the disease, is nothing but gene therapy. So let's see which options are given. Number one, safety testing. Number two, biopiracy. Number three, gene therapy. And number four, molecular diagnosis. So correct answer here is gene therapy. Next question, 117. Match the column. In first column, the structures given, cristae, thylakoids, centromere, cisternae. In second column, various options are given. Cristae are the infoldings of inner membrane in mitochondria. Cristae, this structure is very commonly found in mitochondria. So these are infoldings of mitochondria. Thylakoids, thylakoids are flattened membranous sacs which are arranged one above the other, and they are especially present as grana in the stroma of blastids. जेव्हा थायलाकॉइड सॅक्स एकावर एकावर अरेंज केलं असतं तेव्हा त्याचे स्ट्रक्चर तयार होतं लाईक अ पाईल ऑफ कॉइन्स, राईट? सो दॅट स्ट्रक्चर इज नोन ॲज ग्रॅन अँड इट इज व्हेरी कॉमनली फाउंड इन द स्ट्रोमा ऑफ प्लास्टिड्स, इट मीन्स क्लोरोप्लास्ट, राईट? सेंट्रोमियर इज अ प्रायमरी कन्स्ट्रक्शन इन क्रोमोझोम अँड सिस्टरने दीज आर डिस्क शेप सॅक्स इन गॉल्गी बॉडीज. सिस्टरने इज अ स्ट्रक्चरल एलिमेंट ऑफ गॉल्गी बॉडीज, राईट? सो लेट सी वॉट विल बी द करेक्ट आन्सर. क्रिस्टे, infoldings in mitochondrion. Thylakoid, flattened membranous sacs in stroma of plastids. Centromere, primary constriction in chromosome. And cisternae, disc shaped sacs in Golgi apparatus. So correct match here is found in option number 4. So 4 is correct answer for this question. 118. The factor that leads to founder effect in a population is, what is founder effect? It is the loss of genetic variation that occurs when a new population is established by a very small number of individuals from a larger population, right? And this is the definition for genetic drift. So the factor that leads to founder effect in a population is nothing but genetic drift. So let's see which options are given. Number one, genetic drift. Number two, natural selection. Number three, genetic recombination. And number four, mutation. So correct answer for this question is genetic drift. When the centromere is situated in the middle of two equal arms of chromosomes, the chromosome is referred as, when the centromere is situated in the middle of the chromosome and two equal arms are produced or observed, then it is known as metacentric. Okay, acrocentric, other options, let's see which options are given. Option number one, acrocentric. Second, metacentric. Third, telocentric. And fourth, submetacentric. So metacentric, that is second option, is correct answer. Acrocentric means where chromosome is close to one end. Telocentric, where centromere is generally at the end, at one end. So a very small arm and another very large arm is observed. Submetacentric, it is generally towards the or a little bit away from the center. So one short arm and one long arm in the chromosome is observed when the position of the centromere is submetacentric, right? So correct answer for this question, metacentric, that is option number 2. Gimi are present in. Gimi are asexual, green colored, multicellular buds developed in gemma cups, especially in case of liverworts. And when the gimi become matured, these buds, asexual buds, develop on the thallus. They are detached from the parent thallus and develop into new plant. So gimi actually helps in vegetative reproduction or propagation of liverworts, right? So let's see which options are given. Gimi are present in number 1, some liverworts. Number 2, mosses. Number 3, pteridophytes. And number 4, some gymnosperms. So correct answer should be some liverworts, right? So option is 1. 121. During the purification process of recombinant DNA technology, addition of chilled ethanol precipitates out. right? If we want to isolate DNA in its pure form, then if we add chilled ethanol in the medium, that DNA threads precipitates out, right? And if we insert a glass rod in that medium, and if we rotate that rod, then these DNA threads get wrapped around the rod, and we can isolate DNA in its pure thread-like form. The technique is known as spooling. So this method is especially used for isolation of DNA. So let's see what are the options given. Number one, polysaccharides. Number two, RNA. Number three, DNA. Number four, histone. So this technique, that is addition of chilled ethanol, generally precipitates DNA threads. So DNA, that is option number three, is correct. Match the column. Let's see in column one what is given, column two what is given. In column one, cohesion, adhesion, surface tension, guttation is given. Now cohesion is the mutual attraction between similar molecules. Here in option, mutual attraction among the water molecules is given. Adhesion, that is attraction towards polar surfaces. Adhesion is the mutual attraction between two dissimilar structures, dissimilar molecules, right? Surface tension, it is more observed, or more attraction in liquid phase is observed during surface tension. And guttation is the loss of water in the form of liquid from some plants, especially in case of pteridophytes. Guttation is observed due to root pressure, which occurs through hydathode glands. So for cohesion, correct option is mutual attraction among the water molecules. For adhesion, the correct match is attraction towards polar surfaces. For surface tension, more attraction in liquid phase is the correct match. And for guttation, water loss in liquid state is correct match. So for this question, the correct option is number two. The site of perception of light in plants during photoperiodism. Photoperiodism means the effect of duration of light to induce flowering in the plant, right? So when light stimulus is given to the plant, which part of plant receives that stimulus? So generally leaf in the plant receives that stimulus. In the leaf, due to that light stimulus, a specific chemical is formed, which is called florigen, which is responsible for inducing flowering in the plant. So let's see which options are given. Number one, leaf. Number two, shoot apex. Number three, stem. And number four, axillary bud. So perception of light, the site of perception of light in plants is leaf. So option one is correct answer for this question. The plant hormone used to destroy weeds in a field. So there is one synthetic auxin, 2,4-D, that is 2,4-D dichloroacetic acid. So this 2,4-D is mainly used as weedicide to remove the weed from the field. So options are IBA, second option IAA, third option NAA, and fourth one 2,4-D. So correct answer is 2,4-D. Which of the following algae produce carrageen? Carrageen is a hydrocolloid substance, that is the substance which have capacity to hold water. So this is mainly produced by red algae. So let's see which options are given here. Option number one, blue-green algae. Number two, green algae. Number three, brown algae. And number four, red algae. So red algae generally produces carrageen. So option four is correct. Brown algae even produces a kind of hydrocolloid, which is known as algae, right? Complete the flow chart on central dogma. So here A is showing the process where from DNA, new DNA is formed. So it is replication. B is the process which shows that mRNA is formed from DNA. So the process name is transcription. C is the process which shows that genetic information present on mRNA is decoded, and as a result of which a protein is formed. So the process is known as translation. And D, that is what is the product obtained from mRNA after translation, that is protein. So correct answer A, replication, B, transcription, C, translation, and D, protein. So option number 4 is correct answer for this question, right? 127, which of the following are not secondary metabolites in plants? Option number 1, rubber gums. Number 2, morphine codeine. Number 3, amino acids glucose. Number 4, vinblastine, curcumin. So in all these options, amino acids and glucose are so important materials, substances for a cell. Amino acids are mainly required for producing proteins, and glucose is one of the most preferred source of energy in any living cell. So these are not secondary metabolites. Secondary metabolites are produced by the plants, which are most of the time not essential for the plants, but they have a great economic and ecological importance from human point of view. In this case, rubber and gums are polymeric substances. Morphine and codeine are alkaloids. Vinblastine and curcumin, these are drugs. So these are all secondary metabolites, but amino acid and glucose, these are primary metabolites. Very, very important, right? And they are mainly used for making building blocks in the cells, right? So third option is correct answer for this question. In spite of interspecific competition in nature, which mechanism is competing species might have evolved for their survival? So sometimes what happens, many species may inhabit in the same area, same region, same ecosystem. So whatever available resources are present, then without fighting with each other, these species develop such a phenomena that they may use these resources mutually, right? So when many species use the same resources, natural resources, for their survival, right, in spite of interspecific competition, then this process is known as resource partitioning or partitioning. So let's see what are the options given. Number one, predation. Number two, resource partitioning. Number three, competitive release. And number four, mutualism. So when species inhabiting the same habitat or ecosystem and use the same resources without fighting, in spite of interspecific competition, is known as resource partitioning or partitioning, right? So second option is correct answer for this question. Which of the following is not an application of PCR? Option number one, detection of gene mutation. Number two, molecular diagnosis. Number three, gene amplification. Number four, purification of isolated protein. Correct answer for this question is purification of isolated protein. PCR is mainly used for gene amplification, in vitro gene amplification. And this is a technique where detection of gene mutation is possible, molecular diagnosis is possible. Gene amplification is the process actually, which is known as PCR, that is synthetic gene amplification. So rest of the options show the application of PCR, but purification of isolated protein is not an application of PCR. So correct answer for this question is number four. Now again match the columns. Next question, 130. Cells with active cell division capacity. In plants, such cells are mostly meristematic cells. Tissue having all cells similar in structure and function. Such tissues are called simple tissues in plants. Tissue having different types of cells. These are especially known as complex tissue, and in complex tissue in plants, the examples are xylem and phloem, which are nothing but vascular tissues. Dead cells with highly thickened walls and narrow lumen. These are the types of sclerenchyma cells, which are very commonly known as with narrow lumen. These are sclerids. Okay. So let's see what are the correct matching for this. Cells with active cell division capacity, correct match is meristematic tissue. Tissue having all cells similar in structure and function, correct match is simple tissue. Tissue having different types of cells, correct match is vascular tissue, as it is a complex tissue. And dead cells with highly thickened walls and narrow lumen, the correct match is spherics. So correct option for this is number two. A typical angiosperm embryo sac at maturity is. A typical angiospermic embryo sac is called polygonum type, which was first discovered in polygonum plant, which is always 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. So let's see what are the options given here. Number 1, 8-nucleate, 8-cell. Number 2, 8-nucleate, 7-cell. Number 3, 7-nucleate, 8-cell. And number 4, 7-nucleate, 7-cell. So correct option is 8-nucleate, 7-cell. That is second option. Okay? हा प्रश्न जसा जसा आपल्या आयसीडीएल पेपरमध्ये आलेला आहे, बरेचसे प्रश्न आहेत असे पेपरमध्ये की जे सेम टू सेम आलेले आहेत किंवा त्या कन्सेप्टवरतीच विचारले गेले आहेत. सो द पेपर इज व्हेरी इझी, देर आर नो ट्विस्ट्स इन द क्वेश्चन्स, राईट? इवन दो इन फ्रेमिंग अ काइंड ऑफ ट्विस्ट इज देअर, ऑप्शन्स फॉर दॅट क्वेश्चन गिवन इज व्हेरी गिवन आर व्हेरी सिम्पल. सो क्वेश्चन पेपर इज इन ऑल व्हेरी व्हेरी सिम्पल क्वेश्चन पेपर. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग अल्गी कंटेन्स मॅनिटॉल ॲज रिझर्व फूड मटेरियल? in which algae mannitol laminarin act as a reserve food material in brown algae. You will have to find out the brown algae example in the given option, right? In green algae, it is stored in the form of starch. In brown algae, it is stored in the form of mannitol or laminarin. And in red algae, it is stored in the form of Floridian starch, right? So let's see what are the options. Number 1, Ulothrix. Number 2, Ectocarpus. Number 3, Gracilaria. Number 4, Volvox. So in all these options, Ulothrix, Volvox, green algae, Gracilaria, red algae, only Ectocarpus is brown algae, in which it is stored in the form of mannitol. So correct option for this question, number 2. Next question, 133. Genera like Selaginella and Salvinia produce two kinds of spores. Such plants are known as. So Salvinia and Selaginella, when produces two kinds of spores, the condition is known as heterosporous. So option number 1, heterosporous. Number 2, homosporous. Number 3, heterosporous. And number 4, homosporous. So correct answer is heterosporous. Heterosori. Sori is the group of sporangia. So this term is not applicable to the question, whatever framing given in that question, right? So correct answer is number 1, heterosporous. Mutations in plant cells can be induced by number 1, zitin, number 2, kinetin, number 3, infrared rays, and number 4, gamma rays. Zitin and kinetin, these are hormones, especially cytokinins, right? Infrared rays not used for producing mutation. So the only option left, that is gamma rays, option number 4 is correct for the question, for this question, right? Amensalism can be represented as. Amensalism means it is a symbiotic association between two such organisms where one organism do not have any benefit or harmful effects from the association and the other organism always get harmful effect from that association. Okay. Example, for example, antibiotic producing microbes. Suppose, for example, penicillium. Penicillium produces antibiotic penicillin. So around that penicillium fungi, when it produces penicillin, any other living microorganism cannot grow in that region. So for those other organisms, the effect of penicillin is always harmful. But for penicillium, it don't have any benefit, any harmful effect from the association. So species A minus, that is getting harmful effects, and species B zero, which don't have any benefit or any harmful effect from the association. So for this question, the correct answer is option number 2, species A minus, that is getting negative effect, and species B zero, which don't have any effect of this association on it. So second option is correct answer. What is the role of RNA polymerase 3 in the process of transcription in eukaryotes? Question number 136 now in this paper, section B. First question, what is the role of RNA polymerase 3 in the process of transcription in eukaryotes? So RNA polymerase 3 generally produces tRNA in the form of 5SRRNA, that is 5 small ribosomal RNA, and snRNA, that is small nuclear RNA. RNA polymerase 1 produces ribosomal RNAs like 20S, 28S, 18S, 5.8S, etc. And RNA polymerase 2 in eukaryotes produces precursor of mRNA or hnRNA. So for this question, the correct answer is option number 3, transcribes tRNA, 5SRRNA and 5SNRNA, right? So answer 3 is correct. Select the correct pair. Loose parenchyma cells rupturing the epidermis and forming a lens-shaped opening in the bulb. The given match is spongy parenchyma, which is wrong. These cells are called complementary cells, which forms lenticels in the bulb. Large colorless empty cells in the epidermis of grass leaves. These colorless cells in grass leaves are commonly called bulliform cells. But here the correct match given for this is subsidiary cells. So this match is also wrong. In dicot leaves, vascular bundles are surrounded by large thick walled cells. Match given here is conjunctive tissue, which is wrong. Actually, these cells which surround the vascular bundle, those are called bundle sheath cells. Cells of medullary rays that form part of cambial ring. The match given for this is interfacial cambium. This is the correct match in the given question, right? So correct answer for this question, that is number 4, cells of medullary rays that form part of cambial ring.
which later undergo dedifferentiation and forms interfascicular cambium. Next question, plasmid PBR322 has PST1 restriction enzyme site within gene ampicillin resistance that confers ampicillin resistance. If this enzyme is used for inserting a gene for beta galactoside production and the recombinant plasmid is inserted in an E. coli strain, then what will happen? म्हणजे ampicillin resistance gene जो आहे PBR322 मध्ये, इमॅजिन करा की त्याच जीन मध्ये आपल्याला बीटा गॅलॅक्टोसाइड प्रोडक्शन जीन इन्सर्ट करायचं आहे. समजा इथे ampicillin resistant जीन आहे somewhere here, tetracycline resistant gene is there in the PBR322. तुम्ही डोळ्यासमोर आला फिगर म्हणजे तुम्हाला लक्षात येईल, ठीक आहे, राईट. सो हिअर समवेअर PST1 दिस जीन इज प्रेझेंट. ओके, आता याच्यामध्ये जर आपण बीटा गॅलॅक्टोसाइड प्रोड्युसिंग जीन इन्सर्ट केला तर काय होईल असा प्रश्न, राईट. लेट सी व्हॉट आर द ऑप्शन्स गिवन. इट विल बी एबल टू प्रोड्यूस अ नॉवल प्रोटीन विथ ड्युअल एबिलिटी. नंबर टू, इट विल नॉट बी एबल टू कॉन्फर ॲम्पिसिलिन रेझिस्टन्स टू द होस्ट सेल. नंबर थ्री, द ट्रान्सफॉर्म्ड सेल्स विल हॅव द एबिलिटी टू रेझिस्ट ॲम्पिसिलिन ॲज वेल ॲज प्रोड्यूस बीटा गॅलॅक्टोसाइड. अँड नंबर फोर, इट विल लीड टू लिसिस ऑफ होस्ट सेल. नाव वेन इन antibiotic resistant gene which is in PBR322 used as marker gene, jar ekada marker gene madhe ampicillin resistant tetracycline resistant apan marker gene mhanun vapartho, jar ekada marker gene madhe apan ekada new foreign gene introduce kela, then this marker gene lost its activity, lost its original ability. What is the original ability? If this ampicillin resistant gene is present in this plasmid, then wherever this plasmid is inserted in any host cell, that will give, this gene will give resistance against this particular antibiotic to that host cell. But now due to insertion of foreign gene in this ampicillin resistant gene in E. coli, this gene is unable to provide that resistance against ampicillin to the host cell, because now we are inserting a foreign gene in this marker gene, right? So this is, the process is known as insertional inactivation, when a gene lost its ability due to insertion of a foreign gene in it. The process is known as insertional inactivation. So correct answer for this question is second option, that is it will not be able to confer ampicillin resistance to the host cell. Next question, 139, DNA fingerprinting involves identifying differences in some specific regions in DNA sequence called as. So DNA fingerprinting involves identifying differences in some specific regions in DNA sequence called as repetitive DNA, where repetitive DNA mostly non-coding sequences, right? So in DNA fingerprinting, mainly the sequence of nucleotides which are identified, those are from repetitive DNA. So let's see what are the options given. Number one, polymorphic DNA. Number two, satellite DNA. Number three, repetitive DNA. And number four, single nucleotide. So correct answer for this question is number three, repetitive DNA. In the exponential growth equation, nt equal to n0 e raised to rt, what is e represents? So e actually is the base of natural logarithm. So let's see what are the options given. Option number one, the base of geometric logarithms. Number two, the base of number logarithms. Number three, the base of exponential logarithms. And number four, the base of natural logarithms. So correct answer for this question, number four. Which of the following statements is incorrect? Let's see one by one these statements. Number one, cyclic photophosphorylation involves both PS1 and PS2. No, in cyclic only one pigment system is used, that is PS1. So first statement, रॉंग वाटतंय, बघूया अजून पुढचे काय स्टेटमेंट्स आहेत ते. सेकंड, बोथ एटीपी अँड एनएडीपीएच2 आर सिंथेसाइज ड्युरिंग नॉन सायक्लिक फोटोफॉस्फोरेशन. करेक्ट, स्ट्रोमा लॅमेली हॅव PS1 ओनली अँड लॅक एनएडीपी रिडक्टेज. करेक्ट, इन स्ट्रोमा लॅमेली जनरली ओनली PS1 इज प्रेझेंट, एनएडीपी रिडक्टेज एन्झाइम इज अब्सेंट. सो करेक्ट, ग्रॅना लॅमेली हॅव बोथ PS1 अँड PS2, एस्पेशली दोज ग्रॅना लॅमेली विच आर ओव्हरलॅप्ड. In that overlapping portion, PS2 is present, and in upper and lowermost
grana lamellae generally PS1 is present. So grana lamellae generally have both PS1 and PS2. So this statement is also correct. So statement number 1, cyclic photophosphorylation involves both PS1 and PS2. This is wrong, and that is the correct answer for the question. So correct answer for this question, option number 1. Which of the following statements is correct? Let's see. Option number 1, some of the organisms can fix atmospheric nitrogen in specialized cells called sheath cells. No. Sheath cells mantat ka? Nahi. Kai organism je atmospheric nitrogen fix kartat, specialized cells madhe, those are mainly blue-green algae, and the cells are called heterocyst. Fusion of two cells is called karyogamy. No. When cells are totally fused, cytoplasm as well as nuclei of these cells fused, then it is not karyogamy. Number 3, fusion of protoplasm between two motile or non-motile gametes is called plasmogamy. Correct. When these gametes are fused, initially their cytoplasms get fused, which is called plasmogamy. Later their nuclei get fused, called karyogamy. Right. So third option is correct. Fusion of protoplasm between two motile or non-motile gametes is called plasmogamy. Correct. These steps, plasmogamy, karyogamy, meiosis, observed especially in fungi during sexual reproduction. Number 4 statement, organisms that depend on living plants are called saprophytes. No. When any organism depend on living plants, those are commonly called parasites. Saprophytes are the organisms which grow on dead and decaying organic matter. So option number 3 is correct, and that is the answer for this question. Match the column. Let's see. In column 1, what is given? In column 2, what is given? Column 1, Nitrococcus, Rhizobium, Thiobacillus, Nitrobacterium. Sage bacteria che naav dilele. Column 2, denitrification, conversion of ammonia to nitrite, conversion of nitrite to nitrate, conversion of atmospheric nitrogen to ammonia. Let's see. Nitrococcus is the bacteria which converts ammonia to nitrate, that is NH3 to NO2. Rhizobium is a bacteria which converts atmospheric nitrogen to ammonia, that is N2 to NH3. Thiobacilli is denitrifying bacteria, and which converts NO2 or NO3 to atmospheric nitrogen. And Nitrobacter generally converts ammonia to nitrite. Right. So these are the correct options. So let's see what are the correct match. Number 1, Nitrococcus converts ammonia to nitrite. Number 2, Rhizobium converts atmospheric nitrogen to ammonia. Number 3, Thiobacilli, denitrifying bacteria, denitrification. And number 4, Nitrobacter converts nitrite to nitrate. So correct option is number 2 for this match the column. Which of the following statements is incorrect? Number 1, oxidation reduction reactions produce proton gradient in respiration. Right? So oxidation reduction reaction produce proton gradient respiration, that is correct, because every electron carrier, whatever present as a part of ETS in respiration, that undergo alternate reduction and oxidation. So that is correct, and that results in formation of a proton gradient in the perimitochondrial space in mitochondria, right? So for 143, the correct answer is second one, right? Now next question, 144. Which of the following statements are incorrect, or which of the following statement is incorrect in this question? Let's see the statements. Number 1, oxidation reduction reactions produce proton gradient in respiration. Is it correct? Yes. Whatever carriers, electron carriers present in the respiratory chain, those carriers alternately undergo oxidation and reduction, and that helps to produce proton gradient during the process. So that is correct. During aerobic respiration, role of oxygen is limited to the terminal state. Yes. In the aerobic respiration, oxygen is required only for terminal oxidation, that is formation of metabolic water. When reduced coenzymes transfer their hydrogen to the various carriers present in the electron transport chain, finally these reduced coenzymes get oxidized and oxygen is reduced by forming the metabolic water. So oxygen role is always limited to the terminal state in the aerobic respiration. थ्रूआउट द एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन जेवढे केवढे पाथवे आहेत तिथे कुठेही ऑक्सिजन प्रत्यक्ष लागत नाही. ग्लायकोलिसिसमध्ये लागतो का नाही, ॲसिडायलेशनमध्ये लागतो का नाही, क्रेप सायकलमध्ये लागतो का नाही, पण रिड्यूस्ड कोएन्झाइम जेव्हा फायनली ऑक्सिडाइज होतात त्या ऑक्सिडेशन प्रोसेसमध्ये सुद्धा सगळ्यात शेवटी ऑक्सिजन लागतो. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट. नंबर थ्री, इन इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रान्सपोर्ट चेन वन मॉलिक्युल ऑफ NADH2 गिव्ज राइज टू 2 ATP मॉलिक्युल्स अँड वन FADH2 गिव्ज राइज टू 3 ATP मॉलिक्युल. दिस स्टेटमेंट इज रॉंग. ॲक्च्युअली इन एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन वेन रिड्यूस्ड कोएन्झाइम्स आर ऑक्सिडाइज्ड वन NADH2 प्रोड्यूसेस 3 ATPs अँड वन FADH2 प्रोड्यूसेस ओनली 2 ATPs. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज रॉंग, राईट. लास्ट स्टेटमेंट, ATP सिंथेसाइज थ्रू कॉम्प्लेक्स 5. कॉम्प्लेक्स 5 is made up of ATPases, that is ATP particle, F0, F1 particle. So it is correct. So in the given statement, third statement is wrong and that is the correct answer. So for 144, the correct answer is 3. In some members of, next question, 145, in some members of which of the following pairs of families, pollen grains retain their viability for months after release? We know very well that for different plant species, for their pollen grain, the viability period is different. Viability means the capacity of that pollen grain to germinate on the stigma and producing the pollen tube, right? So this viability is different for different pollen grains from different plant species. So for months in which species the pollen grains retain their viability, the correct answer is rosaceae and leguminosae. So in this question, the first option given is rosaceae leguminosae. That is the correct answer. So for 145, the correct answer is 1. Identify the correct statement from the following. Next, 146 question. Identify the correct statement from the following. First statement, split gene arrangement is characteristic of prokaryotes. Is it correct? No. In prokaryotes, split genes are absent. Split gene means where a single gene consists of functional and non-functional patches, right? And such split genes are commonly found in eukaryotes. They are generally absent in prokaryotes. So first statement is wrong. In capping, methyl guanosine triphosphate is added to the 3' end of HNRNA. This statement is also wrong. Definitely in capping, methyl guanosine triphosphate cap is added, but that is added to the 5' end of HNRNA and not to the 3' end. So this statement is also wrong. RNA, third statement, RNA polymerase binds with rho factor to terminate the process of transcription in bacteria. Yes, during transcription, sigma initiation factor is required to initiate the process of transcription by RNA polymerase. And when this RNA polymerase reaches to the 5' end, for termination, it requires, that is a downstream end, it requires rho factor. So this statement is correct. Fourth statement, the coding strand in a transcription unit is copied to an mRNA. The coding strand in transcription unit is not transcripted, that is it do not undergo transcription, right? The strand of DNA which is transcribed, that is called antisense strand or template strand. Coding strand is opposite to antisense strand, which do not undergo transcription, right? So this statement is wrong. So for 146, the correct statement is third one, and that is the answer. Then question number 147, match column 1 with column 2. So here floral formula given in, different floral formulas are given in column 1, and in column 2 the name of family is given. So the correct answer, first floral formula is that of a family. So this Fabaceae, right? Then second formula given is that of family Solanaceae. Third formula is that of Liliaceae, and fourth formula is that of Brassicaceae. So correct answer for this question is number 2. 148, again match the columns. In column 1 or list 1, they give the biomolecules, that is protein first one, unsaturated fatty acid second one, nucleic acid third one, and then fourth one polysaccharide. And in column 2 they give the bonds present in these biomolecules. So in list 2, C double bonds, right? Phosphodiester bond second, third one glycoside bond, and last one peptide bond. So we know very well that protein have peptide bonds in them. Unsaturated fatty acids have C double bond C. Nucleic acids generally have phosphodiester bond in them, and polysaccharides have glycoside bond. So correct answer or correct match for this is number 2, and that is the answer. Then next one, 149. Again match the columns, list 1 and list 2. In list 1, they give different phases of cell division, that is S phase, G2 phase, quiescent stage and G1 phase. And in list 2, they give proteins are synthesized, inactive phase, interval between mitosis and initiation of DNA replication, and last one, DNA replication. It means which events or which processes occurs in the respective phases. This is given. So let's see. S phase is the phase which is mainly characterized by DNA replication. Then G2 phase is the phase which is the phase in which proteins are mainly synthesized, right? Then quiescent stage is the stage which is inactive phase, so called, because from cell division point of view, this quiescent stage is inactive. That is when the cell enters into the G0 phase, right? Then G1 phase is the phase where it is the interval between mitosis and initiation of DNA replication. So correct match for this, match the column, that is number 4. जर तुम्ही व्यवस्थित मॅच केलं तर तुम्हाला हे आन्सर मिळून जाईल. नाव लास्ट क्वेश्चन 150. नाव डेज इट इज पॉसिबल टू डिटेक्ट द म्युटेटेड जीन कॉजिंग कॅन्सर बाय अलाउंग रेडिओ ॲक्टिव्ह प्रोब टू हायब्रिडाइज इट्स कॉम्प्लिमेंटरी DNA इन अ क्लोन ऑफ सेल्स फॉलोड बाय इट्स डिटेक्शन युझिंग ऑटो रेडिओग्राफी बिकॉज नाव डेज इट इज पॉसिबल टू डिटेक्ट द म्युटेटेड जीन विच कॉजेस कॅन्सर बाय युझिंग सम स्पेसिफिक टेक्निक्स. So let's see what are the options given for this framing of question. Number 1, mutated gene does not appear on photographic film as the probe has complementarity with it. Now in this technique, whatever probe used, that is the normal gene which is not mutated copy, right? So first statement is wrong. Mutated gene partially appears on a photographic film. This is also wrong, because mutated gene have a different sequence of nucleotides in it, so it cannot match with the probe DNA, right? Number 3, the mutated gene completely and clearly appears on a photographic film, which is again wrong. Number 4, mutated gene does not appear on a photographic film as the probe has no complementarity with it. This is the correct answer. See, mutated gene have a change in the sequence of nucleotides, and probe DNA, whatever selected, that is a normal gene with correct sequence of nucleotides. So when we hybridize mutated gene copy with probe DNA, it cannot match with it because it has different kind of sequence of nucleotides. So it do not appear on photographic film as it do not hybridize with probe DNA. So hence, number 4 is correct option. So this is all about 2021 NEET paper, where the code number of paper is P3, right? So all the best for your future plans. Goodbye.